In this video, we will be discussing how to collect blood from cattle and buffaloes. Blood is generally collected for various purposes, like blood test for any abnormalities so that it can be treated properly, various research activities for teaching and learning. Blood is collected generally from the jugular vein. First of all, we should restrain the cattle or buffaloes in the travis or chute in the standing position if the animal is highly ferocious. If animal is cooperative, it can be collected directly from the animal in the standing position. If animal is small, like calf and heifer, and if animal is little bit excited and ferocious, it can be made to lie down on the ground in a proper position with the help of manpower. Once animal is restrained, try to clean the jugular groove or the place where the vein is being run. Once after cleaning, press the jugular groove so that the jugular vein rises. Now take the vacutainer needle, fix it in the adapter. Once you fix it in the adapter, try to puncture the jugular vein. Then take the vacutainer, press it in the adapter. The quantity of blood collected in the test tube depending upon the type of test tube which has the capacity. Some test tube has 5 ml, 10 ml. And the type of blood you want, it decides the color of the test tube or the cap of the test tube. Suppose if you want the serum, generally the test tube used is the red colored cap. If you want plasma, then we have to use either green colored cap so that it will be not uncoagulated because it contains heparin coating. We have one more vacutainer, that is lavender or purple colored cap, which is generally EDTA coated. Once you collect the blood, you see that punctured part does not bleed, or you try to sterilize that area. Now, the amount of blood is to be collected depends upon the purpose. But at any given time, the maximum blood collected is generally 1% of the body weight or 5.5% of the blood volume. The above procedure, although does not require IAEC approval, that is Institute Animal Ethical Committee or CPCAC. However, the experiment involves any special research or novelty or involvement of any drugs or new vaccine studies, and there is a repetitive collection of blood, then the permission from the IAC is very much required.